الله أكبر الله أكبر.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن اهتدى بهداه وبعد. All praise is indeed due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless him and all his companions, and to bless every single one of us, those from amongst us who are the scholars of this deen, as well as those who are not. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us and our offspring and keep us all on this deen, and make every day such that we are closer to Allah than the previous day. Ameen. Honored ulama, beloved brothers and sisters, and dearest listeners. This evening we have the topic of pride and arrogance, and the angles from which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has discussed this issue in the Quran. More than 35 different angles. And amazingly, this issue of pride and arrogance is a very serious matter. Let us take a look through the verses of the Quran where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about pride and arrogance. But before we commence, we need to know the Islamic translation of the term pride. Al-kibru or at-takabburu or al-istikbaru. We should know that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once asked, or he was asked, that, O Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we are people who love to dress properly and we love to have a good conveyance and so on. So you have told us, لَا يَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةَ مَنْ كَانَ فِي قَلْبِهِ مِثْقَالَ حَبَّةٍ مِّنْ خَرْدَلٍ مِّنْ كِبْرٍ. A person who has a mustard seed's weight worth of pride in their heart will never enter Jannah. That's what you told us, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we love to wear good dress and we have good conveyance, meaning the mode of transport. So what about us? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that is not pride. It is not pride to have the best clothing and the best motor vehicle or the best house, the best in terms of material items of this world. That is not what is the meaning of pride. Pride is to reject the truth and to despise people. Two things. We can write that down. If you want to know the meaning of the term pride, one is when the truth is uttered to someone and they reject it, they are proud. May Allah protect us from pride. They are arrogant. May Allah protect us from arrogance. And the second issue, when a person is despising others, belittling them, thinking that he is better than others in any way, then automatically they become from amongst those who have pride and arrogance within them. And this brings us to the first set of verses in the Quran discussing the issue of pride. It goes right to the beginning at Surah Al-Baqarah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chooses to mention the story of the first sin committed in Surah Al-Baqarah. The first sin committed was the sin of arrogance and pride. Haughtiness, if we can call it. When you think you are big, you think you are better. Listen to what happened. Iblis, may the curse of Allah be upon him. The devil himself, Shaytan, Satan as he is called. What happened? He was ordered to prostrate to Adam, may peace be upon him. As the first human being who was created, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Baqarah,
وَإِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةً قَالُوا أَتَجْعَلُ فِيهَا مَنْ يُفْسِدُ فِيهَا.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of his intention firstly. When he told the angels, I am going to create a man, a viceroy on earth. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسَ أَبَى وَاسْتَكْبَرَ وَكَانَ مِنَ الْكَافِرِينَ.
Allah says, remember when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the angels to prostrate to Adam, then all of them prostrated besides Iblis. May Allah's curse be upon him. Aba means he refused. Was takbar, he became arrogant. What type of arrogance is that from the two we mentioned? Is it the arrogance where he is rejecting the truth, or is it that which he is despising people? The Mufassirin have spoken about both. One is, he is despising Adam. In another verse in Surah Al-A'raf, he says,
أَنَا خَيْرٌ مِّنْهُ خَلَقْتَنِي مِنْ نَارٍ وَخَلَقْتَهُ مِنْ طِينٍ.
Oh Allah, I am better than him. Why are you telling me to prostrate to him? You created me from fire and him from dust, from soil. You know, fire is always above. May Allah protect us all. Now this Iblis was quite a saintly person before this crime. But his arrogance led to the wiping out of all his good deeds. And this is why he was so good that he was counted as a member of the family. Meaning he was counted as a member of the malaika, the angels. You know, when someone is very good, what do we say up to this day? We say, oh, he's an angel. Oh, she's an angel. Oh, my little one, and so on. We are so happy because they have angelic qualities. So Iblis had some angelic qualities. And remember, it does not mean he was an angel. Because in the Arabic language, there is, for example, the linguistic use of the language is such that when you say the whole community came, even the donkey, does that mean the donkey is a member of the community? No, it doesn't. But it means it was included because they used it to come. May Allah protect us. So he was the donkey of the lot in the sense that he was considered as part and parcel of the community of the angels, but he was not an angel. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks of this crime. We have a lesson to learn from this, that whenever we think that others are low and others are weak and others are down, that is the first crime, that is the devil's crime himself. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from haughtiness. The second issue, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and this is in Surah An-Nisa, where Allah says about Isa alayhi salam as well as the angels, that they are not proud, they are not arrogant, they know where they fit in. They are not too high to say and declare that they are actually the slaves of Allah. Listen to what Allah says. How many of us are ready to call ourselves slaves? I think none of us would like to be slaves. But of Allah, yes, we are ready. We call ourselves slaves of Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really grant us that title. It is a very high title. So Allah says,
لَنْ يَسْتَنْكِفَ الْمَسِيحُ أَنْ يَكُونَ عَبْدًا لِلَّهِ وَلَا الْمَلَائِكَةُ الْمُقَرَّبُونَ وَمَنْ يَسْتَنْكِفْ عَنْ عِبَادَتِهِ وَيَسْتَكْبِرْ فَسَيَحْشُرُهُمْ إِلَيْهِ جَمِيعًا.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that Isa alayhi salam and the angels, they are not proud to declare that we are the worshippers of Allah and the slaves of Allah. No, they don't have that pride and haughtiness in them. Allah says, whoever has that sort of pride that they don't even want to associate with their own creator, and whoever has arrogance in them, Allah says, we are going to resurrect all of them. May Allah protect us. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, an arrogant person is he who denies the verses of Allah and the laws of Allah. When we are told this is haram, it is haram. If we are committing it, don't ever try to justify it. Declare that it is haram. Don't try and look for loopholes, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will definitely become very angry. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that those who have denied the verses, they are the ones who are arrogant, because it is rejecting the truth. Allah says in Surah Al-A'raf,
وَالَّذِينَ كَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِنَا وَاسْتَكْبَرُوا عَنْهَا أُولَٰئِكَ أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ.
Those who have rejected the signs of Allah, the verses of Allah, the laws of Allah, the regulations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and have become haughty and arrogant, Allah says, for them, they will be the fire of Jahannam. In fact, in another verse, a few verses down, Allah says,
إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِنَا وَاسْتَكْبَرُوا عَنْهَا لَا تُفَتَّحُ لَهُمْ أَبْوَابُ السَّمَاءِ وَلَا يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةَ حَتَّى يَلِجَ الْجَمَلُ فِي سَمِّ الْخِيَاطِ.
What a beautiful example. Allah says, those who deny our verses, those who reject our rules, our regulations, and those who have belied our signs and have become arrogant and haughty, they will never ever enter Jannah. And the doors of the skies will never ever open for them. They will not have goodness in this world, nor will they have goodness in the Akhirah. And Allah says, they will never enter Jannah until the camel enters the needle or the eye of a needle. Can a camel ever enter an eye of a needle? It can never do that. So in other words, they will never ever. It is impossible for them to enter Jannah. Didn't I mention the hadith? Anyone who has a mustard seed's weight worth of pride within them will never ever enter paradise until they seek complete forgiveness for that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us steadfastness. May He protect us from this crime. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about another quality of those who are proud and arrogant. They like to enslave everybody and they want to control all the other people. Just because Allah might have given them a little bit of wealth, just because Allah might have given them good looks, just because Allah might have given them a bit of clout and a bit of power maybe. So they want to control the whole world. They want to control and enslave everybody else. And if those people don't listen to them, they begin to threaten. May Allah protect us. That's a sign of pride. When someone comes and threaten you, he is too arrogant. May Allah protect us. He must talk to you nicely. But the problem is when you threaten someone else, that's the problem. You see, whenever we speak of these topics, sometimes people nod their heads. Yes, it's good to nod our heads. We all do. But let's nod our heads in trying to take heed ourselves, not in saying, yes, it fits for that man. And it fits for that guy. Yeah, I hope he's here. Turn around in the masjid and check. Uncle, are you here? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. That is also from shaitan. He doesn't want us to think it applies to me and you. Wallahi, it applies to myself and yourselves. In that, we need to draw lesson from it. So Allah says, those who want to control and dominate, they should realize that the control is not for them, it is for Allah. We should always want the law of Allah to come first. And every human being is free. They are not enslaved by any other human being. They are enslaved by their creator alone. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us that understanding. So Allah says, in Surah Al-A'raf, قَالَ الْمَلَأُ الَّذِينَ اسْتَكْبَرُوا مِنْ قَوْمِهِ لِلَّذِينَ اسْتُضْعِفُوا لِمَنْ آمَنَ مِنْهُمْ أَتَعْلَمُونَ أَنَّ صَالِحًا مُرْسَلٌ مِّنْ رَبِّهِ. The people of Salih alayhi salam, there were some of them who were arrogant and haughty. They told the weak ones, and the weak ones, some of them who had believed, these people went and found them and called them and says, hey, are you sure you're calling this man a messenger? He's not a messenger. So they said, no, we have believed in him. So these people said, no, we have disbelieved in him. And you know what? If you are not going to come back to what our gods that we were worshipping, and if you are not going to come back to our ways, we're going to kick you out of our community and out of our clique. If you don't toe the line, you've had it. May Allah protect us. These are statements that have smacks of arrogance, not only smacks of arrogance, but far worse. Pride and haughtiness that there is no room for in Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us goodness. So Allah says, after a little while, that they started warning the people, they started threatening the messengers and those who believed.
لَنُخْرِجَنَّكَ يَا شُعَيْبُ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعَكَ مِنْ قَرْيَتِنَا أَوْ لَتَعُودُنَّ فِي مِلَّتِنَا.
O Shu'aib alayhi salam, and those who have accepted with you, we're going to kick you out of this community and this city. You wait and you watch. We're literally going to kick you out unless you come back to us and you regard us as the bosses. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. Allah is the boss. Besides Him, nobody else is the boss. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all understanding. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open the doors for every single one of us. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, whoever wants to fall under those who are arrogant and haughty, they are guilty of the same crime, and when punishment comes to those, these will also be punished. So Allah says, when someone threatens you, if they are wrong, they are wrong. Do not give in to those threats. May Allah protect us. When someone wants to warn you out of arrogance, to say, look, come under my authority, otherwise what? May Allah protect us. Really, it reminds me of a joke on a lighter note. There was a man getting married, and I'm going to divert a little bit seeing that we're early today. There was a man, very soft-natured, getting married, and his wife was stern, the bride. So people started telling him in advance, look, what are you going to do? He says, I don't know. So someone said, you know what you do? The first night, you must put a cat under the bed. And as you enter the room, when the cat comes out, have a big stick and beat the cat so badly that you actually kill it. He said, oh, will that work? He said, yes. So now the first night, subhanallah, he went into the room and the cat came out. He took the stick and began to beat the cat. The wife got scared. And the cat died. He took it out and threw it out of the window. After that, the wife became so obedient. Anytime anything happens, he says, come on, do this or else. So she quickly does it because she doesn't want to listen to what will happen to her. Until a few times, he tried the trick. Then someone told her that, you know what, this man is too soft, man, he's too soft. So one day he said, look, I'd like you to have the tea ready at 7 o'clock, otherwise. So she said, otherwise what? Otherwise I'll have it ready. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all protection. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really grant us understanding. Now we need to know that if you follow someone who is in authority, naturally what will happen is you will be considered as one of those. Obviously this was on a very lighter note. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's forgiveness, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us a lesson as well. So there we are. We have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us that those who are haughty, one of their signs is they are corrupt. They are corrupt as well. You can notice they will be corrupt because their arrogance and their haughtiness makes them feel that they are the ones in authority. Makes them feel that they create the rules. The rules are all theirs. They don't follow any other rules and regulations, whether it is from the Quran or the Sunnah. Even the law of the land they will not uphold. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us a deeper understanding. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of that in Surah Qasas, talking about Fir'aun, who was the most arrogant. Allah says, إِنَّ فِرْعَوْنَ عَلَى فِي الْأَرْضِ. Fir'aun was very high, lofty, he was haughty, he thought he was very high on this earth.
وَجَعَلَ أَهْلَهَا شِيَعًا يَسْتَضْعِفُ طَائِفَةً مِّنْهُمْ يُذَبِّحُ أَبْنَاءَهُمْ وَيَسْتَحِي نِسَاءَهُمْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ مِنَ الْمُفْسِدِينَ.
Allah says, he had created so much mischief on earth. He was slaughtering the boys and he was letting the girls loose because someone had told him that your chair, you know, the chair he was sitting on of authority, is going to be shaken by a man from Banu Israel. So one sorcerer told him that, so he began to kill all the men. He said, look, I can kill all the males, so what? And he started killing them. So Allah says they become oppressive. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. Another sign of arrogance and haughtiness, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, they plan and plot the downfall of others. Allahu Akbar. When someone else is coming high, they want to plan the downfall of that person. That is a sign of pride and arrogance. And Allah says, istikbaran fil ardi wa makra sayyi. Such people, they have haughtiness and pride and arrogance, and they have a bad plan. And do you know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about the bad plan in Surah Fatir? Allah says,
وَلَا يَحِيقُ الْمَكْرُ السَّيِّئُ إِلَّا بِأَهْلِهِ.
The bad plan is not deserving for anyone besides those who have made it. It will come round and attack that same person. It will rebound on them. So when someone plans your downfall, automatically that is their downfall. And if we are planning someone else's downfall, automatically it is our downfall. Because we are meant to be concerned of our own weaknesses and improve our relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls them criminals. And he says, those who have pride in them, those who reject the truth and despise people thinking that they are better than others, making a mock and a joke of others who might be weaker, who might be darker, who might be of a different nationality, who might be, for example, of a lower financial status and so on. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says they are criminals. Those who consider others like this, they are criminals themselves. And this Allah says in Surah Al-Jathiyah, when a question will be asked to those people, فَاسْتَكْبَرْتُمْ وَكُنْتُمْ قَوْمًا مُجْرِمِينَ. Weren't you haughty? Weren't you proud and arrogant? And that made you into criminals. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from criminal behavior. In Surah Yunus, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَاسْتَكْبَرُوا وَكَانُوا قَوْمًا مُجْرِمِينَ. Regarding Fir'aun and his people, Allah says, they were haughty and proud, and that's why they became from amongst the criminals. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that a criminal will not have, or should I say a proud person, a person who's arrogant, does not have the ability to distinguish between what is right and wrong. That's what the Quran says. Listen to what Allah says in Surah Al-A'raf. Look at how bad it is to think that you are better than others. Look at how bad it is to despise people and to look down upon them. Look at how bad it is to reject the truth when it comes to you. Allah says in Surah Al-A'raf,
وَإِنْ يَرَوْا سَبِيلَ الْغَيِّ يَتَّخِذُوهُ سَبِيلًا.
Whenever they see the bad path, they take it as their path because they see it right. So when something is evil, to them it appears good. And Allah says, just the verse before that, or part of the verse, Allah says,
وَإِنْ يَرَوْا سَبِيلَ الرُّشْدِ لَا يَتَّخِذُوهُ سَبِيلًا.
When they see the good path, the path of wisdom, they don't even want to come near it. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explains to us how they've lost balance in the world. Because Allah then calls them from amongst those who are wasteful. They spend money where it is not supposed to be spent. And they do not spend it where it is supposed to be spent. So you can turn blue in your face trying to explain to them, brother, this is a good cause, come and spend here. They will shake their heads. No, I'm not going to give. And then where there is no money needed, they will take the millions and put it there. Allah says, that's a sign that they have pride and arrogance and haughtiness, and Allah has rejected their wealth. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not do that to us. And this Allah says in Surah Ad-Dukhan about Fir'aun,
إِنَّهُ كَانَ عَلِيًا مِّنَ الْمُسْرِفِينَ.
Allah says he was haughty, and he was from amongst those who was very wasteful. He didn't even know where to spend and what to spend on. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all the ability to distinguish between right and wrong, and may He grant us the ability to spend in the right path, and may He protect us from spending in the wrong path. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about the fact that He doesn't guide those who have pride. He doesn't guide those who have pride. He does not guide them until and unless they repent and they come back down to the earth. And this is why we always say that when a person walks with his nose above everybody else's, he thinks he is breathing the air 1 inch above everyone else's. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells him, you know what? I'm not even going to guide you. You are arrogant. You are moving around on earth as though you are the only creature of mine. Allahu Akbar. Do you know we need to hunt for the friends of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Sometimes they are those who work for us as maids and as domestics. Sometimes the Muslims from amongst them are stronger than us, myself and yourself. And we take it for granted. Sometimes there are people you will never believe that this person is so pious. You see them on a daily basis. They might even be begging for money on the street. Possibility that they might be close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, closer than me and you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never make us arrogant in a way that we look down upon anyone. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us really protection from the devil and from shaitan. So Allah says in Surah Ghafir,
كَذَلِكَ يَطْبَعُ اللَّهُ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ قَلْبِ مُتَكَبِّرٍ جَبَّارٍ.
Notice the words kibr, takabbur, mutakabbir. All these words are connected. Allah says, Allah seals the hearts of those who have arrogance and haughtiness, and Allah doesn't want to guide them. Listen to what He says in Surah Al-A'raf.
سَأَصْرِفُ عَنْ آيَاتِيَ الَّذِينَ يَتَكَبَّرُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ بِغَيْرِ الْحَقِّ.
I will turn my signs away from those who have pride and arrogance. Allahu Akbar. When my verses are being read, they won't see the light in it. When you tell them the Quran says this, they'll shake their heads. They just won't see the light. Because they've got a quality in them that prohibits them from, subhanallah, they've got a quality in them that prohibits them from seeing the truth. Because they themselves think that they are far above the truth. May Allah protect us all. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, those who are arrogant and proud, they do not consider other people. They don't even count others. Allah says to them, others don't exist. They are the only ones in existence. And this is a reminder to the youth. As the adolescent child, male and female, grows up, they need reminders, you are not the only human beings on earth, because there is a period where they feel they are the most powerful, bubbling and bursting with every form of energy they have. That is the adolescent teenage, we can call it. And they think, I can hit everybody and I can sort everybody out, and I am the one and I am the Mac, and everybody should look at me and I am the most attractive and I am this and that. No, believe me, there are others. The world is full of people who think just like you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all. That's just a light piece of information for those who are young. And those who are elderly, I would like to hope and pray that we've now come to realize that we are not the only ones on earth. We need to be helpful towards others, and we need to look up to others, and we need to respect every single human being. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide myself and yourselves and everybody else, inshallah. Even the kuffar, may Allah guide them towards the deen. Even the enemies of Islam, may Allah guide them towards Islam. Tomorrow, if the biggest enemy of Islam has to utter the shahada, what did we say a few days back? We said he becomes your brother instantly. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us every form of guidance. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about Fir'aun, that when the truth came to him from people a bit lower than him, do you know what he said? He didn't even count them.
فَقَالُوا أَنُؤْمِنُ لِبَشَرَيْنِ مِثْلِنَا وَقَوْمُهُمَا لَنَا عَابِدُونَ
What? Do you think we're going to accept a message from people who are like us, meaning human beings like us, and their whole community is enslaved by us? They are worshipping us. Banu Israel is worshipping us. They are our workers. How can we accept a message that Allah sends through people who are weaker than us? That's what Fir'aun said. So Allah is telling him that that is a sign of haughtiness. For that, we are going to curse you. Allah says, how can you utter that statement? Allah chooses whom He wants to give value to.
Allahu a'lamu haythu yaj'alu risalatah.
It is Allah who decides where He's going to put His message and who is going to hold it. And remember one thing. Those who have knowledge from amongst us, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the ability to respect them. Because that is, those are the chosen people by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah loves someone, He grants him a deep understanding of the deen. So we need to understand, we better be in the good books of those who have sound knowledge. مَنْ يُرِدِ اللَّهُ بِهِ خَيْرًا يُفَقِّهُ فِي الدِّينِ It is only whom Allah loves and intends goodness from that Allah gives a deep understanding of this deen. And Allah knows where He is going to put His message. He's not going to put it in the hands of a person who is haughty and arrogant, because those qualities would negate the teachings that that person would be teaching had they been teaching the teachings of the messenger. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all a deeper understanding, inshallah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about how when people are arrogant, they ask you to do impossible things before they want to come onto the level or before they allow you into their circle. They tell you, okay, and I want to give a typical example. It might fit, it might not fit, but we'd like to give current examples. You go, you want to sell a product to someone, and you know that he's a very arrogant human being. He doesn't have time of the day for anyone. And you tell him, you know your cost is 5 rands, and you are selling it to him for 5 rands 50. And he tells you, look, I can buy 50,000 from you if you sell it to me for 3 rands. Now what is he telling you? He is telling you something impossible. And believe me, if you tell him, uncle, I'll give you at 2 rands, he still won't buy it from you. That's a fact. Because it's his arrogance that is making him say that. He should sit and realize, this man has worked hard. How can I squeeze him to the degree that he will not even be making a penny? What is the aim of dealing in Islam? Both parties must be happy. One must go home thinking, I've got a good deal. And the other one must go home thinking, mashallah, I did a good sale. Alhamdulillah. Neither must have ripped the other, and nor must one go and curse the other. This is why we say, when you've ripped somebody off, that's the worst thing you could do, because they will curse you without even you knowing and without even them knowing. What does that mean? You sell someone a telephone which costs 100 rands for 500 rands. Then one day they walk down the aisles of a supermarket and they see a brand new phone similar to the one you sold them for 500 for 100. What are they going to do? They won't even know, but they're going to say, "Hey, Allah must fix that guy." That's all. Hey, I was ripped off. That's enough for your curse sometimes for the rest of your life. May Allah protect us. That's why we say don't cheat people. We are Muslimin, be honest. Another thing, if you want to buy, buy. If you don't want to buy, don't buy. If you want to haggle, it is a sunnah to haggle. So you are allowed to say, look brother, with respect. Brother, you know what, come down a bit. Let's talk, you know. Then if he says, what price are you looking at? You don't come and tell him something ridiculous. Give me this phone for 10 rands. That's now pride and haughtiness and arrogance. You're making a fool of someone. Let's continue with our topic. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then says that they come up with impossible things, and when you bring the impossible, still they won't believe and they won't accept. Look what Allah says in Surah Al-Furqan.
وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ لَا يَرْجُونَ لِقَاءَنَا لَوْلَا أُنزِلَ عَلَيْنَا الْمَلَائِكَةُ أَوْ نَرَى رَبَّنَا لَقَدْ اسْتَكْبَرُوا فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ وَعَتَوْ عُتُوًّا كَبِيرًا
Allah says, those who do not believe in the Akhirah, those who are arrogant, those who are proud, those who feel themselves to be haughty, to be higher than others, Allah says, they tell you, look, why don't you bring Allah? You know, why don't you bring Allah or the angels? Or why is it that Allah doesn't come Himself? Allahu Akbar. Why doesn't the angels come down? Why don't the angels come down? Allah says in Surah Al-A'raf, or in Surah Al-An'am,
وَلَوْ أَنَّنَا نَزَّلْنَا إِلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةَ وَكَلَّمَهُمُ الْمَوْتَى وَحَشَرْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ قُبُلًا مَا كَانُوا لِيُؤْمِنُوا.
Even if we were to bring forth for them everybody who died, and if Allah was to come to them, if the messenger was to come to them, meaning if the angels were to come to them and talk to them live and direct, they still wouldn't believe. It's just a statement of arrogance. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us all. Allah says, it is only if Allah intends for someone to be guided that they shall be rightly guided. Then Allah says, those who are proud and arrogant and those who feel that they are better than others, they know the truth. They know that they also suffer, they also go to the loo, they also have diarrhea, just like everybody else. May Allah protect us. They know that they also have family problems, they also have all sorts of other issues. They know what is right, but deep down it is something within them that is devilish, that just stops them from rejecting, meaning from accepting the truth. It just stops them. Listen to what Allah says. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah An-Naml about Fir'aun. And in fact, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions this in a few places in the Quran, in different wordings.
وَجَحَدُوا بِهَا وَاسْتَيْقَنَتْهَا أَنفُسُهُمْ ظُلْمًا وَعُلُوًّا.
Allah says, because they thought they were too high, they rejected the truth, though they knew deep down within them that this is the truth. Allahu Akbar, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never make us from amongst those. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the true believers. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes them in Surah Sajda. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and it's a verse where the sajda is, so I won't read it out right now, but I'll explain it to you. Allah says, definitely those who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whenever they hear the verses of Allah, they immediately surrender to the verses and they fall prostrate and they have no pride. وَهُمْ لَا يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ. They have no pride in them. They do not reject the truth. So we hope we are from amongst those. Whenever someone comes to you and says, listen brother, this is haram. Listen sister, this is haram. If it is sounding a little bit fishy, when I say fishy, I mean it's the first time you've heard it. Don't just reject it. What you do, go out and research it. Go out and find out. Ask other scholars. And believe me, do not try and find a loophole and justify that, no, this is right. I don't care, this is right. You know, this is happening all over Cape Town, or it's happening all over here, or all over the world. How come somebody's coming to tell me today that it's wrong? No, that's a sign of pride. Go and study it, take a look at it, ask if it is what Allah wants, surrender to it, and then you will become from those whom Allah's mercy descends upon, and you will see the mercy coming. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then speaks about how some of these people who are arrogant, they become so deep in their arrogance and haughtiness, they regard themselves as gods besides Allah. They take themselves to be the ones whom entire existence is created for the service of. May Allah protect us. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about Fir'aun. And Allah says he was the most arrogant person to exist. And Allah says, do you know what he said? He says, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَقَالَ فِرْعَوْنُ يَا هَامَانُ.
Or in fact, just a verse before that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَقَالَ فِرْعَوْنُ يَا أَيُّهَا الْمَلَأُ مَا عَلِمْتُ لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَٰهٍ غَيْرِي فَأَوْقِدْ لِي يَا هَامَانُ عَلَى الطِّينِ فَاجْعَلْ لِي صَرْحًا لَعَلِّي أَطَّلِعُ إِلَىٰ إِلَٰهِ مُوسَى.
Fir'aun looked at the people and told his people, oh my people, I don't know of any God for you besides me. I am your God. Allahu Akbar. He says, oh Haman. Haman was one of his men. He says, come here. This Musa is telling me his God is in the sky. So I'd like you to build me a nice big step going up to the heavens, right to the top. I want to go and I want to see where this God is at the top there. Allahu Akbar. Look at the pride. Look at the arrogance. Even a child would not even dare think that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. So what happens to the brain of someone who is arrogant? It gets blocked so much so that they behave worse than children. And they start doing things that everybody would scoff at and laugh at. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all protection. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about how they do not believe in the akhirah. They don't believe in the fact that they have to answer to their creator. When someone is so proud, sometimes we hear people asking a question and it's a valid question. Don't they think they're going to return to Allah? Doesn't this person think they're going to return to Allah? Obviously the question is for all of us. We should remember we are returning to Allah. But this question is even asked by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that they are so proud, so arrogant, they want to reject La ilaha illallah.
إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا إِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ
When it was told to them that don't worship more than one creator, they became arrogant and they started saying, no, no, no. We want to worship this man and that man and his wealth and this person and that person, and we want to worship, you know, so many different things. Allah says only worship one. If you worship more than one, it's a sign of arrogance. Why arrogance? Because you are rejecting the truth. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never make us from those who associate partners with Him. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says they don't believe in the akhirah. They don't believe in the akhirah. Why don't they believe in the akhirah? Had they had any form of answerability to their creator, it would have made them humble. They would have realized that they are also just a number like everybody else. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَاسْتَكْبَرَ هُوَ وَجُنُودُهُ فِي الْأَرْضِ بِغَيْرِ الْحَقِّ وَظَنُّوا أَنَّهُمْ إِلَيْنَا لَا يُرْجَعُونَ
Fir'aun and his people, what did they do? They became very haughty on this earth. And his army as well, and he used them against the people, thinking that he was never going to return to Allah. He thought he was never ever going to return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us conscious of the fact that we are also going to return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at all times. Then Allah says that proud and arrogant people, they will never ever engage in istighfar, because their pride will prohibit them from turning and repenting to Allah. They need to first get rid of that pride, come down to earth, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when they themselves ask for forgiveness, we will then only forgive them. In Surah Nuh, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam complained to his creator. Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam actually complained to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he told Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala,
إني كلما دعوتهم لتغفر لهم جعلوا أصابعهم في آذانهم واستغشوا ثيابهم وأصروا واستكبروا استكبارا.
He says, oh Allah, these people are so proud. Every time I call them and I try and remind them to turn to Allah, to fear you, to try and make tawbah to you, meaning to turn to and to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they put their fingers in their ears and they don't want to listen because of pride and arrogance. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed the people of Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about how whenever these hypocrites in Surah Al-Munafiqun, they are then termed as hypocrites. And Allah says whenever they are reminded to come and turn to Allah, they don't want to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ تَعَالَوْا يَسْتَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ لَوَّوْا رُؤُوسَهُمْ وَرَأَيْتَهُمْ يَصُدُّونَ وَهُمْ مُسْتَكْبِرُونَ
Allah says, when they are told, come to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he will seek forgiveness for you. They put their heads down and they go away. And they are proud and full of arrogance. They don't want to come and surrender to Allah and His Messenger. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us not from amongst those. Allah says,
سواء عليهم أستغفرت لهم أم لم تستغفر لهم لن يغفر الله لهم
It is equal for them. Whether you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whether you seek forgiveness for them or not, we will never forgive them until and unless they seek forgiveness for themselves. Imagine if Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is asking for forgiveness. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if someone has pride, forget about it. I'm never going to forgive them, even if you, the best of creatures, asks for their forgiveness. What is the reason? The ulama have spoken about the reason. They say the reason is, let me explain to you in an example. When you have a child who has done something wrong at the school, something terribly wrong, they have beaten up another child at the school, then the parent gets to hear, and the parent goes to the headmaster and apologizes on behalf of the child who is not apologetic. Will that apology be accepted? No. Because the child is not apologizing. The child is still continuing and thinks he or she is doing right. So the apology of the parent is only valid if the child is remorseful. And if the child feels that they've done wrong and they are also sorry, then the parent can go and say, look, we're sorry and whatever has happened, please, can you forgive us? Don't expel the child. Yes, you are speaking now. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives a similar example to others. And Allah says, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, these people have been reduced to hypocrisy. If you want to seek forgiveness for them, how can I forgive them when they are continuing in their bad ways? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never make us from those who continue in their bad ways and habits. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has warned them very, very strictly. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
أَوَلَمْ يَسِيرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ فَيَنْظُرُوا كَيْفَ كَانَ عَاقِبَةُ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ وَكَانُوا أَشَدَّ مِنْهُمْ قُوَّةِ.
These proud and arrogant people, Allah says in Surah Fatir, can't they travel on earth and see how we have destroyed other nations who are more powerful than them? Don't they think for a moment that we have bigger control over them than anyone else? Allahu Akbar. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really to grant us a lesson whenever we see others being served the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in such a way that we can turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives examples of the previous nations. He says,
فَأَمَّا عَادٌ فَاسْتَكْبَرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ بِغَيْرِ الْحَقِّ وَقَالُوا مَنْ أَشَدُّ مِنَّا قُوَّةِ.
The nation of Aad, Allah says in Surah Fussilat, they were arrogant. They said, oh, who is more powerful than us? We are so powerful, we can even defy the Creator. Take a look at the Titanic. We know it was a huge ship. They said, this will even defy the Creator. What happened? It was made to sink by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in one of the biggest disasters that we've known in the oceans. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us lesson. So Allah says, Aad thought they were the biggest, the strongest. They thought they were the superpowers. And they even said that. And Allah says,
فَأَرْسَلْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ رِيحًا صَرْصَرًا.
We only sent a wind to destroy them. Just the wind. Subhanallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us and never use the wind to destroy us. Sometimes when the wind is blowing a little bit too much here in Cape Town and in Port Elizabeth and in other places, mashallah, I think we hear the sounds and we get a little bit of a tremor. I am sure the level of our iman becomes a little bit higher for a moment. Is that not correct? That is the wind. That's the power of the wind. It's the creature of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the power of the creator of the wind. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. So then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us all that He has punished every single person who has had pride. And the punishment of those who are proud is firstly in the dunya, then at the time of death, then on the day of qiyamah, and then in the life after death. It's a fourfold punishment. It's not like others. The one who is haughty and proud and arrogant and thinks he is better and wants himself to be the boss everywhere, Allah says you will have four punishments. One is in your life before you die. The other is at the point of death, you'll have a terrible death. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of this in the Quran. And Allah says then on the day of Qiyamah there's going to be a disaster for you. Then Allah says after that, in the life after death, I don't even want to make mention. May Allah protect me and may I never be from amongst those. And the same applies with you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save every single one of us from this evil quality of haughtiness and pride. So listen to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. He says,
وَقَارُونَ وَفِرْعَوْنَ وَهَامَانَ وَلَقَدْ جَاءَهُمْ مُوسَى بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ فَاسْتَكْبَرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَمَا كَانُوا سَابِقِينَ.
Allah says, Qarun, Fir'aun, Haman, and the likes, when Musa alayhi salam went to them, they became arrogant and proud and they rejected the truth. So Allah says, do you know what we did to everyone who was arrogant and proud?
فَكُلًّا أَخَذْنَا بِذَنْبِهِ فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ أَرْسَلْنَا عَلَيْهِ حَاصِبًا وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ أَخَذَتْهُ الصَّيْحَةِ وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ خَسَفْنَا بِهِ الْأَرْضِ وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ أَغْرَقْنَا وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيَظْلِمَهُمْ وَلَكِنْ كَانُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ يَظْلِمُونَ.
Allah says every single one of them, we punished them severely. Some of them we sent against them winds.
some of them sounds and volcanic eruptions, some of them we drowned them, some of them we destroyed them by letting the earth swallow them. Allah says, we destroyed every single one of those who were proud. Go and see them. You will not even notice a slight sound about them now, though they were so arrogant and haughty at that particular time. Allah says, we did not oppress them, they oppressed themselves. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. If we've heard such a solid and powerful verse, surely it should move us and shake us, and we should become from amongst those who remove every drop of pride from our hearts. We start greeting people, we start smiling at people, we start talking nicely to people, we start accepting the truth. And this is what will result in our, inshallah, in our success in the dunya as well as in the akhirah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about how a person who is arrogant won't even worship Allah. And when he doesn't worship Allah, Allah becomes angry with him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمُ ادْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. Allah has said, call out to me and I will respond to your call. Worship me and I will accept it.
إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ عَنْ عِبَادَتِي سَيَدْخُلُونَ جَهَنَّمَ دَاخِرِينَ.
Those who don't want to worship me, they will enter the fire of Jahannam. Allahu Akbar. What a direct verse. May we be from amongst those who worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and who fulfill whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's command is. Because it is very rare that Allah says He doesn't like someone. Allahu Akbar. It is very rare. There are just a handful of types of people that Allah says He doesn't like them. And here Allah says, someone who is proud and arrogant, I don't like them. Allah does not use the word hate, because no one must call him the hater. But Allah uses the word I don't like. Listen to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah An-Nahl. Allah says,
إِنَّهُ لَا يُحِبُّ الْمُسْتَكْبِرِينَ.
Allah does not like those who are arrogant and proud. And Allah does not like those who are haughty. Allah does not like those who think themselves better. Allah does not like those who want to control everything. Allah does not like those who want to have the final say in everything when it is against the commands of Allah. If it is within the conforms of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then a person is justified. But as human beings, it's our duty to listen to opinions. Not every time is what you say what is right. Listen to someone else, especially in the house. Listen to your wife sometimes, listen to your husband sometimes. If it is the wife, listen to your children. Give them an ear. See what they have to say. They might have a better opinion than yours. And if that is the case, accept it. Don't reject it. Because if you don't, then it becomes a point of arrogance. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us goodness. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks, and I want to quickly move through the various punishments of a person who's arrogant. Firstly, in the dunya, Allah says, even if they've got wealth, even if they've got power, we will snatch their sleep away from them. We will make their life a misery. We will put problem after problem in their lives, so we will destroy the quality of their life. Though they might have everything that others might consider happiness in life, like wealth, like lots of children, like for example, a lot of good looks and what have you, power, authority, and so on. Allah says, but we can take away. We will make their life a misery because of their pride. Outwardly, they might appear to be very strong people, but inside, they know how much they are suffering because of their pride and arrogance. Their children will be a means of their destruction. Their wealth will be a means of their destruction. And their health will be a means of their destruction. Allah says, remember, we control everything. So don't develop arrogance. May Allah protect us all. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that at the point of death, the angels will tell the arrogant person, take out your soul. This is what Allah has promised you. Listen to what Allah says in Surah Al-An'am.
وَلَوْ تَرَى إِذِ الظَّالِمُونَ فِي غَمَرَاتِ الْمَوْتِ وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ بَاسِطُوا أَيْدِيهِمْ أَخْرِجُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ الْيَوْمَ تُجْزَوْنَ عَذَابَ الْهُونِ بِمَا كُنتُمْ تَقُولُونَ عَلَى اللَّهِ غَيْرَ الْحَقِّ وَكُنْتُمْ عَنْ آيَاتِهِ تَسْتَكْبِرُونَ.
Allah says, the angels will say, on this day of your death, you are already going to start tasting the severe punishment because of your arrogance and denial of the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you rejected the truth, Allah says, as you are dying, we will show you what's going to happen.
May Allah never do that to us. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us from those who take heed. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, on the day of Qiyamah, they will have signs. They will be known by their signs. And there will be a discussion. The people, there will be some people sitting on a wall. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this wall is between Jannah and Jahannam, known as Al-A'raf. And Allah says, the people sitting on the wall will be looking at others, and they'll recognize the proud ones from signs that Allah keeps on their hearts or on their faces. They will be recognized. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-A'raf, regarding the people sitting on that wall, these people on the wall, they will then go to Jannah inshallah, but at one stage they won't know where they are going. As they are sitting on the wall, when they see the proud people passing, going to Jahannam, they will then address them. Allah says,
وَنَادَى أَصْحَابُ الْأَعْرَافِ رِجَالًا يَعْرِفُونَهُمْ بِسِيمَاهُمْ قَالُوا مَا أَغْنَى عَنْكُمْ جَمْعُكُمْ وَمَا كُنْتُمْ تَسْتَكْبِرُونَ.
They will say, oh, you people are going to Jahannam. But you were so many in number, you had so much, you were so haughty, you were so powerful on the earth. Neither did your numbers help you, nor did the increase in wealth and anything help you at all. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that, imagine, some people will recognize the criminals from signs and be mocking at them on that day, because that is the day of mocking. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all understanding. Someone laughed at you here, you'll get a chance to laugh at them in the hereafter. On the day of judgment, you'll get a chance to laugh at them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all. Then their faces will be blackened and they will look down. They will look down, not say anything. Allah says,
وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ تَرَى الَّذِينَ كَذَبُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ وُجُوهُهُمْ مُسْوَدَّةٌ أَلَيْسَ فِي جَهَنَّمَ مَثْوًا لِلْمُتَكَبِّرِينَ.
Allah says, on the day of Qiyamah, you will find the faces of those who had pride and arrogance blackened. Definitely, there is a place in Jahannam, a special place in Jahannam for those who have arrogance and pride. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about in Jahannam, what will happen. And it's amazing how there will be a discussion between the proud and those who followed them. I told you moments ago, when someone follows the proud and arrogant, they will be equal to them in sin. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Saba, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of this verse in several places. Allah says,
يَرُجِعُ بَعْضُهُمْ إِلَىٰ بَعْضٍ الْقَوْلَ يَقُولُ الَّذِينَ اسْتُضْعِفُوا لِلَّذِينَ اسْتَكْبَرُوا لَوْلَا أَنْتُمْ لَكُنَّا مُؤْمِنِينَ قَالَ الَّذِينَ اسْتَكْبَرُوا لِلَّذِينَ اسْتُضْعِفُوا.
Notice how the proud and those who were following them are talking to one another, fighting. So those who were following them will say, if it wasn't for you, we weren't going to be in Jahannam. And in another verse, Allah says,
فَهَلْ أَنْتُمْ مُغْنُونَ عَنَّا نَصِيبًا مِنَ النَّارِ.
Those who were following the arrogant and proud in this world and the haughty, they will be told by those, meaning they will be telling the haughty themselves, that we are in Jahannam because of you, so now you need to take a certain percentage of our punishment. Look at how foolish they are. Allah says, no, you will all be in Jahannam together. The crime of these was that they were arrogant and haughty. And the crime of those was they allowed them to be haughty. Because to be honest with you, when you have someone haughty and arrogant, no matter how much the clout they have, if the whole community boycotts them, your problem is solved. The problem is solved. They will come down to earth because they have to mix. They will realize that I cannot operate on my own. They come to the masjid, nobody greets. They go out, nobody deals with them. They have crucial business dealings, 10 rands less than everybody else, no one buys from them. What will happen? They will come and start greeting everyone. Salaamu alaikum, brother, I've got goods. First time in your life you're talking to me. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. But the problem with us, we have begun to worship money and wealth and power. When we see a powerful person, we become intimidated, and we are not intimidated by our own creator. When we see wealth and money, we then bow our heads to that money. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. If Allah has given it to us, thanks to Him. But it must not make us arrogant. But when Allah has not given it to us, it's even worse. Because the hadith makes mention of the worst arrogant person. You don't get many people who are poor who are arrogant. But Allah says, when you do get them, they are the worst of the lot. And Allah says, they will be from amongst those who will be in the hottest flame of Jahannam. May Allah protect us. A faqir, which means a poor person who is mustakbir, who is proud. You give him 5 rands and he throws it back at you. Allahu Akbar. That person, Allah says, he has nothing to be proud about anyway. The other ones, maybe they have wealth, maybe they've got clout, maybe they've got something. That's very bad. But the worst of them is he who got nothing and he's still proud. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us protection. May He never make us from those. We've got sometimes absolutely nil and still we want to walk on earth as though we are the only ones. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all understanding. So then Allah speaks about how He is going to treat them in the Akhirah. In Surah Al-Ahqaf, Allah addresses those who were proud and Allah says,
أذهبتم طيباتكم في حياتكم الدنيا واستمتعتم بها.
Here in the Akhirah, there's nothing left for you. You've got to go to Jahannam. The reason is, when you were in the dunya, you had a good time, you enjoyed yourself. You had authority, you were proud, you were arrogant, you enjoyed yourself, you did whatever you wanted, and you spent all your coupons, you spent all your good deeds, all gone. So now when you come here, there's nothing for you here. We're not going to oppress you, but you spent everything there. This is why a true believer will lead this life under the instruction of Allah, so that in the life after death, Allah will tell him, you fall under your own instruction. In Jannah, you have what you wish. Allah is not going to control that. Allah tells you, now I want to give you the reins. Ride where you want, do what you want. Allahu Akbar. Imagine. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant that to us. But to get there, we need to first realize that today, here and now, our lives must be under Allah's command. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant that to us. So now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, and this is the final point I'd like to mention. He says, in many different ways, I'm only going to say it in 2-3 different verses. Allah says, make dua that you are not from the arrogant. Allahu Akbar. Look at that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about how the others have made a dua. That Ya Allah, save us from the arrogant. So there's two types of dua. Ya Allah, don't make me arrogant. And Ya Allah, save me from the arrogant. I shouldn't be in their company. I should recognize them. I should distance myself from them. I shouldn't have anything to do with them. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about Musa alayhi salam.
وَقَالَ مُوسَىٰ إِنِّي عُذْتُ بِرَبِّي وَرَبِّكُمْ مِنْ كُلِّ مُتَكَبِّرٍ لَا يُؤْمِنُ بِيَوْمِ الْحِسَابِ.
Allah says, Musa alayhi salam made a dua. Oh Allah, I am definitely seeking refuge in my Rabb and your Rabb, which is Fir'aun's Rabb, which is Allah, still from arrogant people like yourself, meaning Fir'aun. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all from those who are arrogant. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about in Surah Ghafir, the same thing.
الَّذِينَ يُجَادِلُونَ فِي آيَاتِ اللَّهِ بِغَيْرِ سُلْطَانٍ أَتَاهُمْ إِن فِي صُدُورِهِمْ إِلَّا كِبْرٌ مَا هُمْ بِبَالِغِيهِ فَاسْتَعِذْ بِاللَّهِ.
Allah says, they are those who deny the truth, those who reject the meeting with Allah. Allah says, they have arrogance and pride in their hearts. Allah says, you must seek the protection of Allah, that you don't become from amongst them, and you do not even fall within the trap of those who are haughty. You do not support them in any way, and you are in no ways associated with them. May Allah make us from those who can constantly make a dua in this regard, and may Allah protect us from arrogance and haughtiness, and may Allah protect us from supporting those who are arrogant and haughty, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the best of the dunya and the akhirah. Wa sallallahu wa sallama wa baraka ala nabina Muhammad. Subhanallah wa bihamdih. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka.